The Hayworth FFA had a very special guest today. Chad Colby from Cross Implement in Minear came over and gave a presentation on John Deere combines. We also invited all the 8th graders over to visit us while he gave his presentation. On display, we had a 2011 9770 STS John Deere combine, and this combine will actually be harvesting our plot on the upcoming Thursday. Be harvesting our soybean plot. I think everybody enjoyed the presentation that Chad gave, and hopefully we can keep doing this from year to year. Well, here's the video and hope you enjoy. By the way, it was a windy day, so later on when you get to see the video where we're actually outside walking around the combine, some places you'll be able to hear and other places you won't.
Always looking for people. I mean, always looking for new people to come work for me. Whether it's technology, whether it's sales, whether it's mechanical, we're always looking for new people. Ag is so big in this area. Don't forget that as you're looking down your career paths. The next part of the program, we'll talk a little bit about soybeans in Illinois. And we'll get off the shirt. How many acres of soybeans do you think are grown in Illinois? Go ahead. Or hold on, I'll help you first, in case you might want to change your mind. It's millions of acres. It's less than 20 million in Illinois. How many do you think? Take a guess.
18 million.
It's a little less than that.
15. 14.
Somebody's going to go less. Right here.
Six.
It's eight. These are two producers of ours, customers of ours, that farm 12,000 acres with two combines. They work about 18 hours a day, and I mean, these guys hustle. And they've got a fleet of people, motor car drivers, there's three or four semis. You guys have seen these farmers in action. Today's farmer uses a lot of people, uses a lot of staffing, has helped support them. This right here is where threshing begins, where we begin to separate the kernel off of the cob if it's corn or the stem if it's beans. As the material will roll around this rotor, the grain will fall down here. This right here, in this area right here, is a separator, and it's separating the grain out. This right here is a fan that's blowing air through the back of the combine that separates that seed from the debris. The grain will fall on the bottom. Now, you'll see here in a minute, you'll see the grain feeding in, you'll see it spinning through. This other debris will go out the back and will go out the spreader. You'll see the grain fall down through the bottom of these two augers that will then go to the right-hand side of the combine as the combine spins around. You'll see a clean grain elevator that will then lift that grain right here, and then this will hoist the grain up into the tank. We'll take you outside here in just a minute. Who can tell me something special about that photo? What do you see? Anybody see anything special?
The GPS.
Okay, what else? Get more particular.
That's our farm.
Hey! Awesome. Thank you. What's your name?
Carly.
Carly? Good job. Yeah, this is our plot. This spring I came out, I showed you the planter. Most of you must have been there, I believe. We planted the crop. We had our AMS equipment in the planter. Some of you drove it, rode the tractor with me, and it did what? It recorded where we planted, the seeding rates, etc. You see the dome on top of the tractor. We got this little screen in here. So you say, okay, that's cool. Show me the integrated. You go integrated solutions, what that does is, maybe, now we're going to put the same equipment in a combine. Yes, these machines have the capabilities of auto steer and driving by themselves. That's what I put this picture up to show you, this vane right here. That'll cause a combine, if you want to actually drive itself through the field. But what's important is it's recording data the entire time. Yield, moisture, combine settings, all that stuff is being recorded through the this is called a GS3 display. It's pulling all that data. And then the next step of that circle is that data gets recorded, transmitted to satellite, it's put into computer form, and then you can take that data to adjust your operation. You say, well, okay, I understand. Tell me, you're confusing me. What happens is, anybody seen this? There's some farmers in this. Anybody seen this before? What is that? Go ahead and tell us.
A yield map.
It's a yield map. So what happens is while you're in your combine and you're driving back and forth, it's recording the yield data, how good that's corn doing. You're going, Okay, John, your guy. What does that mean? Well, what if your neighbor sells Pioneer corn and your other neighbor sells Stone Seed or DeKalb, and they got a special variety of corn, so you decided to plant half of it over here in Stone, and this half in DeKalb, and then you want some Pioneer in here. That map is going to show you how that corn produces. Just as simple as that. So you can use all this data to make a lot of decisions, and that's the integrated solutions. Right in between here, all the way out. You can actually, if you want to walk up here, you can open that little black door. Go ahead. You can open that little black door and look in there. Basically, what you have is everything down below is where it separates the material from the grain. The other material goes right down through the center of the combine and out the back, okay? What's important about that is all the adjustments you make with the combine is how well of a job the combine does in the field. The grain then falls down to the bottom, kind of where I'm standing. And I'll show you on the other side of the combine where the grain goes up the top, and it goes up in this big tank, and you unload it in this order as it comes out. So let's walk around the back. Spreads it all out behind the machine. Up on top here, Justin will take some guys up there when we split the group, and I'll go to the cab. But up here's the engine compartment, the grain tank where you service it, your fuel tank, all that stuff. When you come around here, watch your head. This is a clean grain right here. Side and then groups of three or four will bring you up into the cab and you guys can look at some.